Good morning, everyone. Steve Whiteside here with your daily market outlook for Tuesday, March 1st, 2011. Now, usually I talk about the pre-market in this part of the presentation, but obviously I can't do that this morning. I'm doing this presentation right around 10 a.m. The markets did open higher, but have had trouble holding those gains. We also had gold and crude oil up this morning after the market opened. Now, I'm running a bit behind schedule. I've been that way for about a week now since my wife had an accident and have not been able to catch up. Had to let some things fall to the sidelines, such as leveraged ETF trends and some of the other presentations, but I hope to get back to those by the end of the week. Taking a look at the VIX, and the VIX is being supported for higher stock prices, came off those highs last week and have been down 3 days in a row. A close below 1772 would give us a new sell signal for the VIX and should correspond with a buy signal in the Dow. We need a close above 12,250 on Tuesday to give us a buy signal. Looking at market breadth, this is the percentage of Dow 30 stocks that are trading above their 10-day moving average. This is short-term market breadth. You can see that we came off those lows last week and have started to move higher, but have not become overbought yet. So low-risk buying opportunities come off the bottom of the range. High-risk opportunities, of course, are at the top of the range. Looking at the S&P 500, we need to close above 1327.46 to give us a buy signal on Tuesday. 155.79 for the S&P Bank Index, 2363.24 for the NASDAQ 100. 463.30 for the SOX index, and for the Dow Transports, we're looking for a close above 5177.16. Now, looking at the other side, for the XAU, gold and silver stocks are still on a buy signal. We need a close below 208.45 to give us a sell signal on Tuesday. For the 30-year bond, 119.52 would be our breakdown point. U.S. dollars starting to crack and has been trading below the low we set a couple of weeks ago. We need a close above 78.04 to give us a buy signal. Now, the euro is still having trouble at the previous high. We need a close below 135.90 to give us a sell signal on Tuesday. Moving over, looking at commodity ETFs, copper is now back on a buy signal. That would change on a daily close below 58.59. The GLD is still on a buy signal. We need a close below 134.95. SLV, 30.81. For gasoline, 44.48. For natural gas, we're now back on a buy signal. That would change on a daily close below 524. And for the USO, for U.S. Crude oil, we're looking for a close below 37.33. Last up this morning, quick look at the 60-minute charts for the S&P 500 cash index. We came off the bottom of the panic zones. Pressure zone was forming at the bottom. We've had a nice move up since the buy signal. We're still projecting higher prices here. We've been able to deal with the two early warning signals so far that have gone off over the past 2 days. We moved it up to our first target yesterday. Our second target is 1335.94. If we can move above that, then 1343.75. Those are our next two targets to the upside. On the downside, we're just above the hourly flypaper channel, which comes in the center points at 1320, which is also yesterday's low. And it's also where the bottom of our channel is right now. So the first sign of weakness, of course, is going to be an hourly close below 1320. Now, starting today, I'm also including an hourly realistic expectations chart for the S&P 500 cash index. This is a projection into the future. Projections into the future are quite interesting. They may not be profitable, but they're certainly interesting. Right now, we're projecting up to the 1362 level. That's farther than I'd be willing to project. Of course, my interest is to go two lines up, which takes me to 1343.75. So right now, this model is still bullish. But of course, if we break down below 1320, we can take the model and rip it into shreds and throw it in the garbage, because once we start breaking down below 1320, we know the model has broken. So right now, 1362, it's the projection. Let's see how long it lasts. And of course, an hourly close below 1320 kicks us out of this market on an intraday basis. Last up this morning, the VIX. The VIX is being supported for higher stock prices. It's in a downtrend. A close above 1924 would tell us that money's flowing back into stock options, and that could lead us to lower prices. One of the things I'm concerned about right now is the fact that we're having trouble getting below the bottom of this, the top of this open gap. And so that's acting as support right now. It'd be nice to see us go back and at least try to fill that gap. But right now, that gap is acting as support, And of course, support for the VIX means lower stock prices. Okay, that's all for Tuesday morning. Again, I'm sorry for the delay this morning. We'll try to do better tomorrow morning and get this out before the market opens. Have a great day, and we'll talk to you again on Wednesday morning.